you're no stranger to the rain. So go rest high on that mountain. The sun, your work on earth is done. Go to gathered round your grave to grieve. Wish I could see angels' faces when they hear your sweet voice sing. So go rest high.
Life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, they shall live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. I lived and I died, and behold, I am alive again. Let us bow in prayer together. Lord God, as we come today to praise your name and worship you and to celebrate the life of Rick Bryan, we pray, dear God, that you be with each individual here. Help them to hold tight to the memories that they have of Rick, and help us through these difficult times of saying goodbye. For it is in Jesus' holy name that we pray. Amen.
When I think back on these times and the dreams we left behind, I'll be glad, 'cause I was blessed to get to have you in my life. When I look back on these days, I'll look and see your face. You were right there for me. In my dreams I always see you soar above the sky. In my heart there'll always be a place for you for all my life. I'll keep a part of you with me, and everywhere I am there you'll be. And I always will remember all the strength you gave to me. Your love made me make it through. Oh, I owe so much to you. You were right there for me. In my dreams I'll always see you soar above the sky.
Robert Lau. I'm the chaplain with Hospice of the Foothills, and when Rick was on our service, I became his chaplain. But then later on, Rick had to depart from our service and go to the veterans home in Anderson, and that's when I became his friend. Rick was a wonderful man. I had a great time getting to know him, and unfortunately, both of us were very much alike because we both had a very sick sense of humor. And we always had a good time together. We would sit out on the back deck and watch the birds. And Rick really enjoyed the simple things in life all the time. He enjoyed sitting out there on a day like today with the blue sky and the puffy white clouds floating across it. And we watched the birds going from tree to tree, and saw Brenda's beautiful gardens out there. That green thumb is definitely a gift to y'all. And Rick, I think Rick inherited a little bit of that because he knew what to do with the flowers every now and then. We'd go out and do something with them. But I enjoyed getting to know Rick, and we had a very good time together. So today, this service should be truly a celebration of his life. But during times like this, in the times of death, we turn to the scriptures. And all of you are probably, if you're from this area, you most likely know the 23rd Psalm by heart. But I want to read it for you, and I want you to listen carefully to the words, because the words of this psalm have so much meaning in times like this. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. And yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. I don't know if you've ever given it much thought or heard about it, but that psalm was written by a man who was a shepherd, David. David was a shepherd who later became a king. He knew exactly what it meant to have a good shepherd and to be a good shepherd. Now, a good shepherd, watching over his flock, knows each of his sheep personally, just as God knows each and every one of us. God knows everything about us, just like a shepherd does. He knows the cry of a sheep's voice, knows what sheep it is that's crying. He knows exactly what we're looked like, and even knows the number of hairs on the top of our head. And in my case, he doesn't have to count very far, so it's pretty easy for God in that case. But God watches over us each and every day, just like a good shepherd watches over his sheep. He makes us to lie down in green pastures, gives us peace and calmness each day of our lives. Have you ever gone and just laid down in a pasture and looked up at the sky? I can remember doing that as a boy and even as an adult, and how peaceful that is just to watch the clouds floating overhead, especially on a nice fall afternoon when the wind's blowing a little bit. He leads us beside the still waters. He gives us rest and peace and calmness. He restoreth my soul. He gives us healing at all times. You know, we talk about healing, and I have a lot of patients who the family wants them to be healed. And I always have to tell them that, you know, I'm sure that God will heal this person, but it may not be in the way that we want, in the way that we seek. But God is always there to help us through the hard times and the good times. I always tell people that the reason that we have the hard times is because if we lived on the mountaintop all the time, we would never appreciate the mountaintop. We would learn for it to just be mundane. It's when we go down into the valleys of life that we appreciate the mountaintop. And God gives us that time and time again through his creation, through the birds flying in the air, and the squirrels running across the yard. And Rick and I surely enjoyed watching all that. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow us through the days of our life. God is always present with us, and he always makes things pleasing. He gives us enough to get through each and every day. None of us lack for food. None of us lack for anything. God gives us an abundance all the time. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Today we have gathered to say goodbye to Rick. But today that goodbye is only temporary, because through our faith and through his faith, we will see him again. Rick was a good Christian man. He knew a lot about the Bible. He and I talked about the 23rd Psalm a good bit and talked about what God did for us each and every day. We enjoyed definitely watching those birds and watching the green grass grow and the blue sky. And each of those things is a gift to us. We oftentimes overlook all that. And I'm not a poet, and I'm not a big fan of poetry, but I have a poem here I'd like to read for you. And I think this, in a lot of ways, exemplifies the way Rick truly was. The poem is called Slow Dance. It was written by a young lady, a teenager, who had terminal cancer in New York. It goes like this. Have you ever watched kids on a merry-go-round or listened to the reins slapping on the ground? Ever followed a butterfly's erratic flight or gazed at the sun fading into night? You better slow down. Don't dance so fast. Time is short. The music won't last. Do you run through each day on the fly? When you ask, how are you doing? Do you wait and hear the reply? With the next day's chores running through our heads, we sleep in the bed and have those running through our heads each night. You better slow down. Don't dance so fast. Time is short. The music won't last. Ever told your child, we'll do it tomorrow, and in your haste, not see his sorrow? Ever lost touch? Let a good friendship die, because you never had the time to call and say hi. You'd better slow down. Don't dance so fast. Time is short. The music won't last. When you run so fast to get somewhere, you miss half the fun of getting there. When you worry and hurry through your day, it's like an unopened gift thrown away. Life is not a race. Do take it slower. Hear the music before the song is over. Rick definitely slowed down and listened to the music. I should have known we would have country music here today. Knowing Rick, he loved the country music. Rick was a very, very talented man. He was a great photographer. He was had a lot of wisdom in his thoughts, even though they came out funny sometimes. I told you he and I have a sixth sense of humor, so we used to sit on the back deck a lot of times and tell each other our latest jokes. And sometimes they would make you laugh. Sometimes they'd make you wonder what the punchline was. But I enjoyed my life with Rick. And I will hold on tightly to the memories that I have of him, just as you will. Rick was a character, for sure. And in the book, A Purpose-Driven Life, written by Rick Warren, he says the purpose of life is to develop our character, to prepare us for death, and to get us ready for when our time is up here on earth. Rick definitely developed his character, and always had fun with him. And I'm sure all of you have memories that you'll hold on to dearly for the rest of your life. Brenda, he's going to be sitting up here on your shoulder. And when you do something crazy, he's going to let you know it for sure. He was a wonderful man, and I thoroughly enjoyed being with him. Romans 8:28 says, all things work together to good according to God's purpose for those who love him and care about him. In the book, The Purpose-Driven Life, we all have purpose, and everything in our lives has purpose. We have the purpose of being gathered here today. In my life, I faced my own death twice in my lifetime. According to the doctors, I'm supposed to be dead, and I told Rick all about this. And I don't believe that God gave me two brain tumors. I think that happened when sin entered the world. That's when we started having pain and diseases and death and sorrows and things like that. But I do believe that God walked with me every step of the way to help me get through those troubled times. Just as He's here today to walk with each one of us during these times of saying goodbye to a loved one. There's another poem that I heard many years ago, and it goes like this. Isn't it strange that princes and kings and clowns that caper in sawdust rings and common folk like you and me are builders for eternity? To each is given a bag of tools, a shapeless mass, and a book of rules. And each must make, ere time is flown, a stumbling block or a stepping stone. Throughout Rick's life, he made an awful lot of stepping stones. That bag of tools is the character that we're given at birth, the talents that we're given. And Rick had the talent of photography. He had the talent of making people laugh. He had the talent of making people feel comfortable. Plus, he was a romantic as well. I went to see Rick after I had an accident on my motorcycle and broke my ankle and my left hand. So at that time, my wife had to drive me around to see patients. So I would she would park out in the driveway. I'd go in and meet with the patient. When I went into Rick and Rick found out my wife was out there, we had to go out and talk with her too. But when we went out there, being the romantic that he was, he had to take some of Brenda's beautiful flowers and pick the blooms off and hand them to my wife. That's the kind of person he was. He was always giving. He wasn't self-centered. He was a person who cared about others. Isn't it strange that princes and kings and clowns that caper in sawdust rings and common folk like you and me are builders for eternity? To each is given a bag of tools, a shapeless mass, and a book of rules. And each must make, ere time is flown, a stumbling block or a stepping stone. The stepping stones that Rick made lead right to the gates of heaven, and we will see him there again someday. Let us bow in prayer. Lord God, I thank you for my friend Rick. I'm sorry that he's no longer here on earth, but Lord, he's not suffering anymore. He's not in a body that was riddled with disease. He's now with you, dear Lord. And what we know through our faith, he now knows as fact because he stands before you. And we thank you for that. And again, dear Lord, through our faith, we will see him again. For it's in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
He's a 20-year straight, get to work on time. He's a loved one woman for all his life. He's a shirt off his back, give you his last dime. He's strong. He's in need to move something, you can use my truck. He's an overtime worker when the bills pile up. Everybody knows he ain't just tough. He's strong, strong. He'll pick you up and won't let you down. Rock solid inside out. Somebody you can trust. Steady as the sun. Ain't nothing gonna knock him off the road he's rolling on. He's strong. It's a dirt road lesson talking to his kids about how to hold your ground and how to live strong. He's strong. He'll pick you up, won't let you down. Rock solid inside out. Somebody you can trust. Steady as the sun. Ain't nothing gonna knock him off the road.
three of the shells that were just fired by the Honor Guard. Today they will be placed in the folds of our flag. They represent duty. Honor. And country.
For almost 250 years, the United States has been a free country. We've been a free country because of some 46 million men and women like Mr. Bryan have worn the military uniforms of our great nation to see to it that we remain a strong and free nation. A resilient military has kept this country free for all these years. Today, our country's sick. But we have about 350 million great, strong, and resilient citizens who are going to see to it that we're going to get better. And we'll be a stronger and freer country because of this special kind of war that we're going through today. We'll come back because, like our men and women who've worn our military uniforms, our citizens are strong and resilient. Today, on the authority of the President of the United States, on behalf of millions of Mr. Bryan's veteran friends still with us today, and especially his friends from the Walhalla American Legion, I'm honored to present this banner that he loved so much and served so faithfully under with the Air Force during the Vietnam War. I'm honored to present this memorial banner to his family. Young fellow sitting here in the front row today who will long remember the solemn occasion. And the older he gets, the more he will remember, and the fonder will become the memories of his grandfather and what his grandfather meant to the freedom of the country that he will be enjoying years from now. I'm equally honored to present this red, white, and blue banner to Mr. Bryan's grandson.
Eli, I know you'll remember your granddad in a very special way. Let's bow together, please. Dear God, once again, we thank you for the memories that we have of Rick. Help us as we leave this place to do as Rick did and build stepping stones that do lead right to the gates of heaven. May everyone here go in peace and love. For it's in Jesus' holy name that we pray. Amen.
When the rain's blowing in your face, and the whole world is on your case, I would offer you a warm embrace to make you feel my love. the evening shadows and the stars appear, and there is no one to dry your tears. I could hold you for a million years to make you feel my love. I know you haven't made your mind up yet, but I would never do you wrong. I've known it from the moment that we met, so no doubt in my mind where you belong. I'd go hungry, I'd go black and blue, I'd go crawling down the avenue. There ain't nothing that I wouldn't do to make you feel my love. Storms are raging on a rolling sea, and down the highway of regret, the winds of change are blowing wild and free. You ain't seen nothing like me yet. There ain't nothing that I wouldn't do, go to the ends of the earth for you, make you happy, make your dreams come true, to make you feel my love.